to the base. One draw, one tie. It wins by way of KO. Introducing Ma Jealousy. And the original player representing New Zealand is having a big passion. He comes to us tonight with a bad record of 7 victories, 4 defeats, 1 draw. Bell rings, the man in charge of the action is referee Chris Sampson.
Okay, touch gloves, protect yourselves all the time.
Bit of trouble with the microphone, but we're getting our first glimpse of Mark Gelsey over there in the corner. The Melbourne fighter. And they might be talking about the Ramoy. No. Chris Sampson's waiting to call the fighters into the centre. Joe Hopkins is ready. And a very, very popular fighter, Joe Hopkins. And he's actually getting the documentary made on him tonight, so hope it goes well. The southpaw, out he comes, and wow, there's plenty of feeling in this one. Straight into the action at 100 miles an hour, worth a lot of feeling. So you can see the power from both fighters. Mate Gelsey, you hit. He picked up the fight when one of Don Miller's fighters couldn't make it. So happy to be here with the opportunity to fight for a title. Backed into the corner now by Hopkins. Trying to cut the ring off and a beautiful left hand. And this could be over before it begun. The count is going to beat him. No. Well, he shows his toughness. He's like those resilient Aussies that we've come to know. The count finishes. Ian Gibson, medic in the corner, ready to have a look. He's Chris Sampson said, okay. Crashing left hand from Hopkins. He tried to get another one away. And what happened there? Did he trip over the ref or what happened? I'd have to watch that one again. But the count goes on. Something, I don't think anything was close to him, but as I say, long way forced back into the corner. Looks over to his corner. Hopkins tries to land the shot again. Gelsey crashes the knee into the thigh of Hopkins, and that's where we leave round number one, and we're over into his corner of Mark Gelsey, and a settling down period, I would say.
Always security needs IPS if you need it.
Keep your right way, you know.
Keep your security detail at all, from private functions to hospitality. Right up with a good job, just contact Lee at IPS, Lee at IPS.
Seven wins have come by the short route, and he favours the hands to finish his opponents. 31-year-old, he trains security guard dogs. He with the big suit on, like you see them doing. really wrapped up in those dogs. And he's got to bring the mongrel out here in round number two. And, ooh, well, he puts those hands to good use there. And Hopkins just on the outside of him. And now tries to tie up. So there goes the first elbow from Galsy. But you can see the power in the hands. Nice front kick from him. Stops Hopkins only momentarily. And, wow. That looked like it had a little bit of an effect, that body shot from Joe Hopkins. It looked like it was going to be an early night at the office for him. He's still trying to work that way. Trying to force the head down. Galsy having nothing to do with that. And back to the action they go, out into the centre. Into the striking range. Wow, there goes the knee. I told you before that he'd ended a fight with the knees. He's just about ended another one. I think he has ended another one. Galsy does the forward roll, takes the big deep breaths and prepares to meet the onslaught again. Hopkins. What's he going to hit him with this time? First of all, it was the left hand. Then it was the knee. Now he goes to the body shots. Galsy is on wobbly legs. And can't wait for the bell. Still got enough power, though, to turn things around if Hopkins gets sloppy. And takes a shot to the body. And Hopkins, he's had an early night at the office and done it in style. Galsy. He was up to his feet, but Chris Sampson had seen enough and waved it off. And Joe Hopkins, the man who just started his own business, Southpaw Electrical. So you want any electrical work done? No job too big, no job too small. We're actually working in the tunnel at the moment. So good contract for a young man to have, just starting his business. Very proficient all-round sort of a fighter. Good with the knees, good with the hands, good with the kicks. Strong in the grapple. And Galsy, who had a good yarn too earlier on in the night. Good sportsmanship from him. He was caught cold. He did his best to fight back. He was unable to withstand the challenge. Picked himself up and would have carried on if it hadn't been for Chris Hatton. Well, he's the holder of the WKBF light welterweight, light middleweight title, so he adds this one to it.